union operator. So what is A union B? The strings that are present in A and the strings that are present in B will belong to the will belong to the language of A union B. Right, again all the strings will be of length 1. So here, because all the strings are of length 1 here, again all the strings will be of length 1 here. So next is going to be the concatenation. So what is concatenation? So the string of the string that belongs to language A is going to be concatenated with the strings of language B. That is concatenation. Okay, so here with regard to concatenation, the first part of the string should belong to language A, the next part should be B, because here we are proposing a language AB, right? So here you can see A concatenated with 0, A concatenated with 1, B concatenated with 0, likewise it goes on. What about BA? So here B should come first and A should come next, right? So that is going to be B concatenated with A. So the next operator what we have discussed is, and then next we have discussed powers of the language. So powers of the language, in the sense, it is going to be nothing but concatenation. Based upon the powers, we will be proceeding with concatenation. That is A part 2 means A is concatenated twice. A part 1 means A is concatenated once. That is A part 1, in the sense, it is going to have the strings that are present, that is language of A and language of A par 1 is going to be equivalent, right? And next is A square. So what is A square? A concatenated with A is A square, right? So here you can see this example. The strings that belong to language A is concatenated with the strings of this part, right? So A and A are concatenated. So what does it mean? So here AA is possible, AB is possible, AC is possible, BA is possible, BB is possible, BC is possible, like it goes on. So what will be the length of the strings in this language? It will be of length 2, because all the strings of language A is of length 1. So correspondingly, all the strings of language AA will be of length 2. What is A cube? Again, A is going to be concatenated thrice. Right, A is possible, that is AAB is possible, BAC is possible, likewise it goes on, right? So in the first position, that is if I am, it is going to be AAA, right? So it is going to be 3 different positions. So the character, that is the first part should belong to this language, and the next part should belong to this language, and the next part should belong to this language. That's it, right? So here all the strings will be of length 3, that likewise it goes on. So here we will be dealing with one more operator, that is clean closure, right? We'll be dealing with one operator, that is clean closure. So what is clean closure? So in the case of clean closure, it is going to be, it is represented by asterisk. It is nothing but 0 to more. A, that is that particular, that is clean closure of A represents. A is going to be concatenated 0 or more times. A is concatenated 0 or more times. So what is going to be possible? 0, in the sense A is concatenated 0 times. So already we have discussed there is possibility of empty string, right? So empty string is represented by epsilon, okay? So here you can see in the case of clean closure of A, epsilon is also possible. Epsilon is possible, A is possible, B is possible, AA, AB. Likewise, it goes on, and the length of the string can be anything. Right, so that is A comma B combination is going to be concatenated any number of times, 0 or more. It can be concatenated 0 times, that is epsilon 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, likewise it goes on till infinity, right? It can be, that is, it is going to be of infinite length. So this is with regard to clean closure. So the next, I hope I have just given an overview of positive closure, I hope. So that the positive closure is represented by plus, right? Positive closure is represented by plus. So here positive closure is nothing but 1 or more, right? 1 or more. Here it is 0 or more. Here it is 1 or more. So meaning in the case of positive closure of A, this epsilon is not possible. Okay, empty is not possible in positive closure of A. So if suppose your string should be of at least length 1, then we have to proceed with positive closure of A. right? So it's going to be A, B, A, A, B. Likewise, it goes on till infinity. The only difference between positive closure of A and the clean closure of A is nothing but, so epsilon, that is empty string, is possible in clean closure of A. The rest is going to be similar. Whereas in positive closure of A, the string should be of at least length 1. All right. So the next what we have discussed is, yes, already we have discussed, right? So what we have discussed is A union B. But so here we have discussed A union B, and then A union B is nothing but A union B is concatenated once. And next, A union B concatenated twice. So what is the meaning? A union B square, right? So here, what is the thing? A union B, we will be having this set, and the next A union B, we will be having the same set again, and I can have combination of these two. That is, in first position, I can have A, B, A or B or 0 or 1, and similarly, in the second position, I can have A or B or 0 or 1, right? And similarly, A union B cube, that is A union B is concatenated thrice. So meaning, in the first position, I can have A, B, 0 or 1. Second position, I can have A or B or 0 or 1. In third position, I can have A or B or 0 or 1. Likewise, it goes on. So here we are going to discuss A union B star. So I have asked you to try it out, right? So what will be the possible strings of this language? Hey, somebody come up, ma. Why no response? Please do try it out. Please do open up. Can you all hear me?
Yes, ma'am.
Huh? Can you hear me?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, can you please give me some answers? Please do give some answers, ma'am. Okay, here we have discussed what is A union B, right? This is A union B. So what is A union B star? So here it is going to be. So what is A union B star? In the sense, it includes A union B power 0. So what is A union B power 0? It is going to be epsilon, right? It is epsilon. And next comes A union B concatenated once. So what is possible? A is possible, B is possible, 0 is possible, 1 is possible. And next comes A union B concatenated twice. So what is possible? A possible, A B possible, 0 0 possible, 0 B possible, likewise it goes on, right? And similarly, A union B concatenated thrice, A union B concatenated 4 times, likewise it goes on, right? So I can have strings of, yes, I can have strings of any length, right? So it is going to be of infinity. A union B star, I can have strings of any length. Are you clear with this?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes,
ma'am.
Yes, good. Okay. Okay, here this is with respect to the operations on languages, right? So here next what we are going to proceed with, a brief intro with regard to the grammars. So in detail, we will be dealing with the grammars later. So for each and every language, we will be dealing with the different types of grammar. So for regular, so here we will be discussing already, I hope we have seen an OOB. That is, first we will be discussing the, regular languages, right? So for regular languages, we will be having regular grammar. Okay, so each and every grammar will be having certain constraints. Those constraints we can discuss later. So just we can have an overview of the grammar. So what a grammar means, that's what we are going to discuss now. Right, so here you can see this is a grammar. So here with regard to the grammar, it is going to have 4 tuples, 4 entities, right? So 4 tuples. So here we'll be having non-terminals, terminals, set of productions and the statistics. So please make a note, just an overview I am giving you. So it will be clear when we see further examples, how to write a grammar, all those details, so how to write a grammar, what are the types of grammar, that we are going to discuss later. Just an overview we are discussing, that's it, right? So here for a grammar, there are four entities, right? So non-terminus, terminus, set of productions, and the start state. So here non-terminus by convention. So here you can see, V represents the non-terminus, and T represents the terminals, and P represents the set of productions, and S represents the start symbol. So what is the use of the grammar? Grammar, so for example, for English grammar, right? So what is the use of the grammar? The grammar helps you to generate sentences, right? So it helps you to generate sentences that belong to that particular language. Randomly, I cannot put the words to form a sentence, right? So here, similarly, with the help of this grammar, I can generate the strings that belong to the language. Okay, so here the grammar is nothing but a generator of a language. It's called as the generator. Okay, how it is going to generate these strings of a language? That's what we are going to see now. So here, what is a non-terminal and what is a terminal? So here, non-terminal is nothing but the non-terminal symbol will be having sequence of productions. So productions in the sense, yes is having, that is from yes, I am having some set of things, right? So yes derives ASBS, right? Whereas if you talk of, so here you can see three different terms, yes, A and B. So here, you can see three different, epsilon is nothing but empty, okay, leave it. So here you can see three different things, that is S, capital, small a and small b, right? So here for small a and small b, we are not having any productions. It is terminating after a, after you, when you see an a, we cannot proceed further. If you see an s, we will be in a position to proceed further. Right. So here S is going to be, S is having production. So S is a non-terminal. So here please make a note, when we define a grammar, we'll be defined which are the terms that forms the non-terminals and which are the terms that forms the terminals. But by general convention, but by seeing, right? So it is not mandatory thing, but the general convention follow this. The capital letters are used to represent the non-terminals. Small letters, numbers, symbols are the terminal symbols, right? Let me repeat. So by general convention, the capital letters are used to represent the non-terminals, and the small letter alphabets, and then numbers, and then operators, whatever it may be, any operator, right? So all those are terminal symbols. Okay, so here we can start with, here we can have, yes, here we can see three different productions, right? S derives A, S, B, S. This is one production. Then S derives B, S, A, S is one production, and S derives epsilon is another production, right? So here you can see, using this production, I can form a sentence that belongs, sentence or string, okay? Sentence that belongs to the language, okay? So how to proceed with that generation? So here, in this case, we are having only one non-terminal, so we can choose any one of the production to start with. But generally, but it is not that we will be having only one non-terminal, we'll be having a set of non-terminals, right? So in that case, one of the non-terminals will be acting as the start symbol. So only with that symbol, I have to proceed with starting the sentence, generating the sentence, right? So here you can see it is mentioned that, yes, so it is mentioned that S is the start symbol. So I am going to, I can start with the S, right? So yeah, I can take any of the productions, okay? So let me take this production, S derives A, S, B, S, okay? So here, please make a note, I cannot, I have to proceed in this way, or I have to proceed in this way, right? I can proceed scanning through the sentence in this direction, or I can proceed scanning through the sentence in this direction. Okay, I am going to proceed in this direction, right? Whenever I am going to see a non-terminal, I am going to proceed with the reduction part. Here we can start with. So what is the first term we are seeing? Terminal symbol. So leave it. So next, move on. Okay, so what I am seeing? I am seeing a non-terminal, yes. So for this non-terminal, I can use any one of the production. Okay, just for example, let me consider I am using this production. So instead of this yes, I am going to replace it by this production. Okay, so BS, AS. So please make a note, only for this yes I am making a replacement. Okay, only for this yes I am making a replacement. So here this is the part. Okay, so the rest is going to be the existing one. I have taken this. Now again scan. So here scanning. Again, I am seeing a non-terminal here. I can use any one of the production to for a reduction process. Okay. So here, let us consider I am using this one. Okay. So here, A, B. So instead of S, I am using an epsilon. So epsilon represents it is going to be empty, right? So empty. So it is going to be reduced like this. So S is going to be reduced to empty. So I am moving on further. This is the next non-terminal. Again, for this non-terminal, I can use this production, or use this production. In order to store, I would like to create a sentence at the earliest. So I am going to replace it by this production, right? So I am going to generate a simpler term. So I am going to reduce this with epsilon, right? So A, B, A, B, yes. Okay, next term, move. So this is the next non-terminal. Okay, so again I am going to replace it by epsilon. So if I am replacing it by epsilon, I will be getting A, B, A, B. If suppose, let us consider I am replacing with this term, what happens? A, B, A, B. So instead of this yes, I can replace it with A, S, B, S. Okay, A, S, B, S. So what I can do now, again I can proceed with, so replace this with epsilon. So B, again replace this with epsilon B. Okay, so here based upon the production, so here you can see I have generated a string that belongs to this particular language. I have generated the string belongs to the particular language. So here again we can see an example, another example, right? So yes, in this example we have chosen this particular production, S derives B, S, A, S. Here in this case we are scanning in this way. Okay, we are scanning in this way. Okay, so here please make a note here, in order to proceed with the derivation, we can deal with the rightmost derivation or leftmost derivation. So in the case of rightmost derivation, the rightmost term is going to be reduced first. So instead, the leftmost term is going to be leftmost non-terminal is going to be reduced. Okay, so here we can start with so here we are going to reduce this term. So this, in this case, No. I think we have reduced in this direction only. Right. Okay, fine. So here, please make a note here. So here, instead of this S, it is reduced to epsilon. So we got BAS, right? We got BAS. So here again, for this S, we have replaced it by ASBS, right? ASBS. So again, this term, right? This term. So instead of this S, it is going to be replaced by, okay, so instead of this yes, it is replaced by BSAS. Okay, so here again, instead of this yes, it is replaced with the epsilon, and instead of this yes, it is replaced with epsilon, and instead of this yes, it is replaced with epsilon. So at the end we got the sentence BAABAB. So using this grammar, at this point we have generated two different sentences, right? So these two are the strings that belongs to this particular language. So like this, we can generate n number of sentences, right? Are you clear with this? Is that clear?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes. Okay. We are having one more grammar, right? So we are having this grammar. So here, what are the non-terminals present here? Here we are having four non-terminals, right? Four non-terminals. So yes. So that's what by general convention we used to have. Please make a note. This A and this A are not the same. Okay, that's what. So non-terminals. Here this A and this A is different. This small A is acting as a terminal, and this capital A is acting as a non-terminal. Likewise, it goes on for the rest. Okay. So here capital A is capital A, B, C are the non-terminals. Small A, B, C are the terminal symbols, and here we are having how many productions? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 productions are there, right? 5 productions are there. And what is mentioned here, though there are 4 non-terminals, only one is represented as the designated as the start symbol. Okay, so one will be designated as the start symbol. So if I want to start proceeding with start generating a string, I can start only with the productions of S. Please make a note. I am having how many non-terminals? 4 non-terminals. S is a non-terminal, A is a non-terminal, B is a non-terminal, C is a non-terminal, right? Among all these 4 non-terminal, I can use only S as the starting production. I cannot use A or B or C. Okay. So based upon the start symbol only, the production will proceed further. Okay, so here in this case I can choose, yes, it's a start symbol, right? I can either choose this production or this production. Okay, so here in this example we have chosen this production. Yes, derives A, B, C. So here this is the first non-terminal, so this non-terminal should be reduced. What about the productions of A? There is only one production. Again, there may be a possibility of multiple productions. So in this case we are having only one production, that is A derives small A. So instead of A, it is replaced with small A. Okay, so which is the next non-terminal? B is the next non-terminal, so productions of B. So only one production, so replace it. So based upon the requirement, so if, for example, if I am having 2 different productions, right? So this may be a possibility. Okay, this may be a possibility, or this may be a possibility. Anything can be a possibility, right? So based upon the language, the productions will be defined. So if in this case I can either choose this production or this production based upon my requirement. Okay, so here in this example we have only one production of B, so I am choosing this one. So this B is replaced with this B, and next non-terminal is C. So C is replaced with this C. Okay, so this is the case. So if I am choosing this particular production, I am getting the sentence ABC. If suppose I am choosing this production, so what will be the derivation? So here this is a non-terminal, so I am going to reduce this to B, right? And again this is the non-terminal, again reduce this to productions of C. Is that clear? Are you clear with this? Say yes or no, ma? Huh?
Yes, ma.
Yes, ma, right? So, yes, ma.
Can you please tell like the importance of the start symbol? So does it mean that we can only start with that S is ABC or S is BC? The A to A and B to B, we can't start with them. Does that mean that, or?
Yes, 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 yes. What you are saying is right. I cannot produce a sentence A. So here, for example, if you are asked whether this A belongs to this language, no, it doesn't belong to this language, right? Only if suppose A is a start symbol, right? So if A is a start symbol, so please make a note here. Here in this case, S is a start symbol, right? So what are the strings possible in this language? A, B, C and B, C are only the possible strings, right? If suppose A is a start symbol, right? So which is the possible string that belongs to this language? If suppose A is a start symbol, which is the possible string of this language?
Small a.
Small a alone, right? If B is a start symbol, which will be the possible string?
Small a.
small b alone, right? So none of the other productions can be used. So for example, if suppose I am having b derives bs or b. So if suppose this is the case, then if b is the start symbol, okay, if b is the start symbol, then what I can do, I can choose this production, and in that case productions of s will be used. Okay, in that case I can use productions of s, that is s is replaced by a b c, and this a is replaced by a, right, b a b c, and again this b is going to be replaced by, again I can use this one or this one, right, I can use this one or this one. Okay, so b a, so let us consider for this one I am choosing this, right, so here b s c, this is capital c, right. Okay, so let us consider now this is the next non terminal, so in that case let me consider for this s I am going to choose this one b c c, so here again this is the next non terminal, let me consider this is going to be the term chosen, so here in this case b c c, again this non terminal which is replaced by small c, again next non terminal let me replace it by small c, is that clear now?
Yes, got it. Yes. Thank you.
Good. That's what, please do make a note if you are having, if you are not comfortable, please do stop and then ask me, clear your doubts. Okay. So if you are moving further, if it is not, if you are not clear with the previous topics, then you cannot understand the rest of the topics, right? Okay. Okay. Please make a note here, this union operator, right, what we discussed earlier, a union b, right, so this operator is also represented by this or operator bar, right, or it is represented by this addition operator. Okay, so here if you come across a term like this, then it means a union b. If you come across a term like this, then it means a union b. Please make a note of it. All these things, all these operators are used for union operation. Okay, so here please make a note of this question. I think hope you can do it later. A is equal to a comma b, b is equal to 0 comma 1, and b. So what will be the possible set of strings, Mark?
Epsilon.
Possible set of strings that belong to this language. As you say, for A star, what is possible? Epsilon is possible. A is possible. B is possible. A, B, B, A, A, B, A, B. That is with combinations of A and B, I can have strings of any length, right? So it is, doesn't matter in which position A should come and which position B should come, right? So this is how A star is. But what about B? So what we have given? What is this? A star concatenated with B. A star concatenated with B. So what is, what are the strings possible? If A star is epsilon, okay, so let us consider A star is epsilon. So here in A star, what are the strings possible? Epsilon is possible. A is possible. B is possible. A, B is possible. A, A, B is possible. B, A is possible. Likewise, it goes on. Whereas in the case of B, which is possible? 0 and 1 are only possible. So is epsilon concatenated with 0?
0.
Yes. Epsilon concatenated with 1?
1.
A concatenated with the 0?
A0.
A0, A1, B0, B1, AAB1, BAB0, likewise it goes on, right? So the only thing is that the first part, what this language defines is, all the strings of this language should end with B. Okay, so it should either end with 0 or end with 1. All the strings of this language will either end with 0 or end with 1. Okay, so with regard to the initial part, I can even have epsilon. So, but then now at the end, I should either have 0 or 1, right? Are you clear with the operations on languages?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, good. Okay, so now we can have an overview of the automata, right? So already we have discussed with this one. So what is automata? So automata is nothing but moving from one state. That is, it is nothing but automation. Automation in the sense we are transition from one state to the another based upon a given input. One state to the another based upon a given input, right? So in the case of what we are going to initially discuss is finite automata. In the case of finite automata, we will be having the knowledge, that is your machine will be having the knowledge of only the current state. Okay, so based upon the input, it will move from one state to the other, and that particular current state will only be known to it. So that's what we discussed with respect to a switch. So it will be initially in the off position. If I push that switch, it will move on to the on state, right? It will move on to the on state. If suppose again I am giving the input push, again it will move on to the off state. So if it is in this state, if I move from this state to this state, it cannot remember this particular state. Okay, it cannot remember the previous state. It cannot move on to the previous state. Only on a given input, it can move from one state to the other, right? So here, yes, already we have discussed a practical example of a documentation. Okay, so here we are going to see an overview of an automata with respect to a valid C identifier. Okay, so please wait. Okay, so valid C identifier. So here in this case, what are the constraints of the valid C identifier? So here, that is valid C identifier in the sense variables. If you want to define a variable name, what are the constraints? So the constraint is that it should either start with an alphabet, that is a letter, or an underscore. The rest of the characters can be a letter, digit, or underscore, and then none of the special characters are allowed other than the underscore, right? And then with regard to the length of the string, it can be of anything. The string of the, that is the length of the variable name, can be anything. Okay, so here we can start with, so what are the things that should be represented in letters? So here letter in the sense, so here what is given, the first character can be a letter or an underscore, right? First character, so please make a note, difference between the letter and digits here. So in the first position, I can have a letter or underscore, whereas the rest of the positions, I can have a letter, digit or underscore. Okay, so here underscore and letters comes in, that is alphabets come in, under one combination. Letter and that is alphabets and underscore come under one combination. So what I'm going to do is all the alphabets, whether it is a capital letter or small letter, that's what. So if you talk of the alphabets, it can either be in capital letter or the small letter. So all the capital letters and small letters are categorized under the name letter. Okay, that is, I'm going to define the language from the base level to the higher level. Okay, define the language from the base level to the higher level. So in the base level, first all the alphabets and the underscore are going to be grouped under the language named letter. Okay, so here you can see all the alphabets, small letter alphabets, capital letter alphabets, and the underscore. So why we are grouping underscore here is nothing but in the constraint, the first position when we are considering, we are the underscore also treated same with respect to the alphabets. Only because of that we are having the combination of this underscore along with the alphabets, right? And next comes digits. So 0 to 9 are categorized or named as language digit, right? Okay, so what about how to represent? So okay, first we can, okay, so here what is the constraint? Here you can see, so in the first position I should have either have a letter combination, right, and the rest of the position I can have the letter or digit, and this letter or digit can be repeated any number of times. So please make a note over here, the first position I should have a symbol that comes under this category, and in the rest of the position I can have the characters from this category or this category, and there is no restriction on the length at all, right? So in order to specify the first position, what should be there? So I should have a letter, right? So letter should be the first character, right? And what about the next part? So first character is defined here. First character is defined here. So what about the next part? The next part I can have a letter or digit. I can have letter or digit. Is there any restrictions on the number of letters and digit? No, I can have. So I can have any number of letters or digit combination, right? So the length of the variable, there is no restriction on the length of the variable name. The length of the variable name can be 1, 2, 3 or anything, infinity, right? So the length of the variable name can be anything. So please make a note over here. So this is going to be the mandatory thing. When we talk of this part, I can have even epsilon. I can have even epsilon. So what I can do? So I'm going to give a clean closure of letter union digit star. Okay, so letter concatenated with the letter union digit star. Are you clear with the this expression?
Yes.
Okay. So please make a note over here. So you first understand the constraints of this language. If you are clear with the constraints of this language, then we can very well proceed with the defining an expression for it. Right. So here, what is given? The letter and letter and underscore are treated the same. That is, letter in this case we are talking of the alphabets. Alphabets and underscore are treated as same. So we are categorizing the alphabets and underscore under one combination, and rest of the characters we are only constrained is with respect to the first character of the variable name, right? And then rest of the part I can have any combination of letters, digit and underscore, right? So that's what we are defining here. The letter, it is going to be a combination of all the alphabets along with the underscore, and in digits we are categorizing the numbers, right, 0 to 1, and we are going to write the expression which represents the valid C identifier. So here we have to define it from the define the regular expression, define this expression from the base level. So here we are having two different two different categories we are defining here. So for first part we are defining one restriction, and for rest of the part we are defining another set of restrictions. So for first part, what we are having, letter or underscore is allowed. So that is going to be defined by this language. So I am having this part here. Okay. And for this part, what is the restriction? I can have combination of letter or digit, which can be concatenated any number of times. This part can have, can be of any length. I can either have epsilon in this part. I can even have epsilon here. Okay, so the only constraint is that this is a mandatory part and this is going to be an optional one. So epsilon should also be possible. So where we will be getting, so in clean closure, we'll be getting that part, right? If suppose, let us consider, right? Please make a note over here. Let us consider we are having a constraint that the identifiers should be of length at least 2. Okay, and the rest of the constraint is same. So the first is going to be letter or underscore, and the rest of the part can be of anything, letter or digit, but it should be of length at least 2. So what can be my operator used here? That is, epsilon is not allowed now, right? Epsilon positive is not allowed.
Positive closure.
Yes, good. So instead of this, I can go for positive closure, right? Are you clear with this? Is that clear? Say yes or no, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am. Good. Okay, fine. Okay, it's almost time. It's not, it will not be sufficient. There won't be any sufficient time if you proceed further. Okay. So if you have any doubts, you can, are you comfortable with the today's session?
Yes.
Yeah. What about others? Only one voice I could hear.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, good, good, good. Okay, at least with water. Yes, okay, ma'am. Okay, if you have any doubts, you can please ask me. Let me download that, right?
Yes, ma'am.